This is my RCA Victrola model 5H. I can't get the platter off with one hand. Hold on a second. Okay, there we go. Model 5H, serial number L0135, and what appears to be a 4. I had this apart, and if we can lift this up here, without it falling off the table, you can see there's the main spring. It's a single spring motor. There's the governor spinning. That I oiled the governor in the main bearings. I did not take apart the main spring because it didn't seem to be. It pops a little bit when it starts to wind down, but it's not too bad. Overall, the inside of the case that's right here is the sound horn. It's a formed, what appears to be either some sort of plastic or a paper mache kind of thing. Not really exactly sure what that is. But the other problem that I had with it was that the horn, the tone arm, I guess you could call it, it had a C-clip on there that didn't really fit. It must have been replaced at some point in time. And it was a real thin one, so that the arm would move up and down and get stuck, and then it would just skip. So now I replaced it with it. When I had bought this, it actually had a clip in a little paper pouch that fit, and it moves back and forth it now smoothly, and it hits it has stops, so it doesn't move too far. The other problem was right here on the part that connects to the reproducer. This was very wobbly and loose, which it isn't now. Temporarily, I just wrapped some scotch tape around it because I'm not sure how that's supposed to be. It still catches a little bit right here, but it's free moving when it's on the record. So let's get the rest of it back together, get the screws back in the case, and we'll play a couple records on it, see how it sounds. Okay, now I have it all back together, a new needle in the reproducer, and I've got her all cranked up and ready to go. Now, the needles that I'm using are Siren needles. I found these on eBay. They're made by Chamberlain. They're a variable tone needle. Let's see if it'll focus here. That's not focusing right. But as you can see, they're kind of spear shaped, and if you play them this way, it's a softer tone. If you play it this way, it's a louder tone. And now we're going to play Wreck of the Old 97 by Vernon Dalhart. And if any of you have seen my other videos, this was played before, which of course when I still had my old camera, but I got comments that it was playing too fast, a couple other things I don't exactly remember, but we'll see how it does now with the governor all oiled up and everything, because I was having problems with the speed control as well. So let's see how it works.
happen, you must putter in center on time. He looks round a bit to his black greasy bum. Just shove on in a little more coal. And when we cross that white old mountain, you can watch your 97 roll. It's a mighty rough road from Lynchburg to Danville in a line on a 3 mile grade. It was on that grade that he lost his average, and you see what a jump he made. Going down grade, making 90 miles an hour, when his whistle broke into a scream. He was found in the wreck with his hand on the throttle and assaulted to death with a scream. Now, ladies, you must take warning from this time now and on. Never speak hard words.
Okay, well, I think that turned out better than the last time, that's for sure. Now, this Victrola, I cannot seem to find any information on it anywhere as of what year it was made, how, like, I can tell it's a later model because it is the RCA, but other than that, I can't really find any information on it. I've looked on websites dealing only with Victrolas, and they don't even list the model 5H. I've seen, I believe, one other user that on YouTube that has one. I forget his name right now, I'm sorry, but if anybody has any sort of information, just let me know. I appreciate it. But we'll get a couple more records played here, have a couple more videos, and then I guess that's it.